Princess, come get your treat. Yes, now you're talking.
We have three dogs and a cat, and they all have a lot of fur.
Come on, I need some more hair. Yes, what a good girl you are.
So whenever our pillows on our couches get a little flat, we just add some fur stuffing to it.
Do you think the dogs know the difference between the dog hair that's in here or the cat hair?
They don't care. It's a good pillow.
True.
My name is Shelley Watson, and I would rather die than pay retail or pay a full price for anything. When I was younger, I didn't know that my parents were frugal. It was just the way we were. My dad is a retired teacher, and they live in a very expensive, elite area in Oregon, but he was never a doctor or a lawyer or anything like the rest of the people who live there.
It smells good. What's for dinner?
We're having family pasta night.
Tracy and I have been married for over 30 years. He is also from a bargaining family. His mother is the bargaining queen. I'm just a princess compared to her.
Do you want to smush while I put the...
Sure.
...the noodles in?
I go to my neighbors to see what leftover pasta they have. They just save it for me.
And I put them all into one pot. And so we have just a hodgepodge of all the different pastas.
I've always been frugal, and I've taught my daughters to be the same way.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, Ash.
Hi.
Colby, we're in here.
We're in the kitchen.
I am the oldest of my family, which means my mom has taught me how to be cheap the longest.
You want to take over the stern system?
Sure.
I've almost got it all smushed.
Okay. I am married to the love of my life, Colby, and we've been married for almost 8 years now.
Put me to work. What can I do for you guys?
Do you want to get the Parmesan out of the refrigerator? Parmesan cheese?
Sure. You know, Shelley just finds all these crazy ways to save money and to do things that people will never think of. Like, I honestly have no idea what goes on in that brain of hers. But for new people, it's almost like culture shock.
It's done.
It's done?
Mm-hmm.
Let's get the strainer.
All right, let me grab that. Ready?
Yeah, be careful. There you go.
My mom and dad have had that racket for as long as I can remember. Honestly, you could probably spend a couple dollars and buy a colander, but it works just fine, and so that's what they use. Hey, bye. We're back here.
I never really noticed how cheap my family actually is until I introduced some of my friends or like my boyfriend to my family. Like, this is really weird. My mom, whenever, you know how like when you're in the shower and your hair falls out and stuff, like my mom would keep it and she'll make her hair pieces with it so that she doesn't have to buy them.
Hey guys.
Hi.
So
Shane is my fiance. I was a little scared to actually bring him into my family and show him like, okay, I know this isn't really normal, but here it is.
Here, Shane, do you want to carry these?
My parents are relatively cheap. With six kids, a lot of clothes were handed down to each one. But as far as being in the Watsons range, probably not even close.
Yeah, if you want more tomato sauce, then just use the ketchup here.
Yeah.
And if you want soy sauce, and then we have the Parmesan cheese left over from when we got pizza the other night.
Anytime we order out, we always ask for extra condiments, anything that they're willing to put in for free.
All right, so Shane, why don't you go ahead and start, but remember to keep the plastic on your paper plate because we're gonna reuse the paper plates, okay?
Arizona is a drought state, and we've had water bills before that have been $300 or $400. So we try to not use the dishwasher as much as we possibly can, and that's one of the reasons that we use the plastic wrap and the paper plates. And now, because we conserve water so much, we're down to under $100.
Why couldn't you put the saran wrap on the breakable plates?
Well, because the paper plates cost less than the breakable plates. They're like, what, 3 to 5 cents a piece? And then the Saran wrap is only like not even a penny. And you're gonna reuse that Saran wrap. So I'm saving like 500% just by doing it that way. And we reuse the paper plate over and over and over again.
Can you hand me the ketchup?
The ketchup?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Here you go.
Come in, do you want it?
Okay. Do you still have your wedding pictures?
Yeah, obviously.
Because I wanted to look at them to get some ideas.
Okay.
For the wedding.
My mom planned our wedding for under $1,000. This is where we're getting married?
Yes.
There's a net on the ceiling.
It's free because my friends work here.
I can't.
You guys, it's
the ceiling's falling off.
It's gonna be fine.
It's falling off.
But I honestly think it turned out great. We had it in a school gymnasium. We had Christmas flowers as our decor. We had cheese sandwiches. We did BYOB. I got to marry Colby.
You may now kiss the bride.
And our guests will never forget it.
You know that we don't want our wedding like Ashley's. No offense, your guys' was...
Ours was great. Everyone remembers it. I just want to let you know not one single guest has forgotten our wedding.
We are very different people.
All right, tell us what you want.
I don't know. I wanted, I don't know, maybe like a country club.
Okay, keep going. No, keep going.
What else?
It's like fairy lights. I like those. Those are really cute. Maybe like rose petals down the aisle. That'd be really pretty.
I want something that's pretty much just out of a fairy tale.
Well, why don't we talk about the budget of what we're willing to pay?
Yeah, do you even know the budget yet?
I've only heard you guys say there was a budget, and I can only assume that's not great.
You know how much we spent on Ashley's?
$1,000.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And this time, I would like to do yours for less. I would like to do yours for $750.
I knew it wasn't going to be a grand wedding as much as I want it to be, but $750? What the f*** is that?
I'm Shelley Watson.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Follow me into the showroom.
Awesome. This is such a beautiful place.
Thank you.
Come on in.
Today, we're going to go wedding dress shopping for Brittany. It's definitely out of the ordinary for me to take my daughters to a place where we're going to buy something brand new. But she has high-end dresses that have been deeply discounted.
What's your least expensive dress that you have?
Well, right here would be $400.
Hmm. Okay, well, do you have, like, anything that maybe was a return that you can come down on the price on, or maybe a consignment?
Typically, we don't do consignment, and typically all sales are final, so there isn't any returns.
I am definitely beyond a bargain hunter. I will find the bargain, and then I will bargain for the bargain.
Do you ever rent your dresses? Like, just for a day?
No.
Okay.
These dresses were all very high-end, expensive dresses. This typically would have sold for about $2,000.
Oh, wow.
All right, so what's the budget for the dress again?
The wedding itself, mm-hmm. I want to spend only $750. So that's including the dress.
Okay.
So we've got to go with as inexpensive as possible.
That may be a little bit hard to do. I can show you what we have, and we can see where we go from there.
I don't consider myself cheap or a cheapskate. I consider myself to be smart. Spending full price for anything drives me crazy. It gives me anxiety.
Do you have anybody that's buying a dress that is getting married before my daughter that would let us borrow it from them, maybe if you had names of people?
It's not really part of my business model. There's frugal and there's cheap, and I'm very respectful of frugal. But cheap is a little out there. I know where you're going, and I'm doing the best I can, but I think we just have to show you what we have, and...
With Ashley's dress, we went to a pawn shop that had a few wedding dresses to select from and found a beautiful gown. Paid $75 because in the back of it, there was a little rat pee stain. But it gave us a really good deal on a very expensive gown.
Hello there.
Hi. Hi.
I'm sure you know this lady here.
Hi, Mom.
Hey, hon. Hey.
I'm so excited.
Oh, this is so beautiful.
This is really nice.
It is nice.
This place is really nice. I didn't really expect this, especially not from my mom. I was half expecting a pawn shop. This is a lot nicer than a pawn shop.
Yeah. Why don't we just start on the right note and have a little cocktail? I have some champagne back here. So go ahead, take your little bag off and I'll go get you some.
This is nice.
It is nice. She has a great little setup here.
And one for Mom.
Right.
Maybe we can get the budget up a little bit.
I don't know about that.
I'm really nervous. I don't know what my mom has in store. She always has something up her sleeve. She always has some type of cheap backup plan. I'm excited about all the pretty dresses I see, but I don't know what's next.
So I have a couple of dresses that I think will look great on you. So shall we go try them on?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, we'll be right out.
Okay.
Those were pretty.
Yeah, this is a nice shop. Way nicer than the pawn shop.
So we've got to be a little creative here. I'm just not sure that this is the price range for us.
Are you ready for the first reveal?
Yes.
All right. This is, I thought, would be a nice style for her, but I think it's maybe a little too revealing for her.
Yeah, I agree.
So how much is this one?
This one's $6.
Oh, well, good thing you don't like it.
In terms of being cheap, on a scale of 0 to 10, 10 being the worst, Shelly's an 11. Okay, are you ready to see your beautiful daughter as a bride? Come on in.
Oh, I love that.
Oh, now that's pretty.
Isn't that beautiful on her?
It is.
It's simple, but it's lace. Because it's got a corseted back, requires no alterations.
So how much is this dress?
Unfortunately, this one is $600.
$600, okay. Yes. So Brittany, that one is not in our budget.
Yes.
So I was thinking, since you do alterations.
Yes, ma'am.
Maybe we could have her put this dress on.
Okay.
This is
my wedding dress. My wedding dress.
Your rappy wedding dress.
There, can you go put this on?
Why?
Because I want to see if it fits you, because then we could just have this altered to fit you, and then we don't have to spend $600 on a dress.
I don't even know why we're here.
Okay, come on in, Miss Bride.
It looks great.
Oh, she got it to cover up here.
Yeah.
I wonder how.
I know that thing zips up. I'm going to do it. Okay, so what if we did this?
That's so up way too high.
It is. Okay, so what if all we did was just hold your boobs? Okay. So what if we just like brought it down just a little? And what if we like crisscrossed it? So you have like nice cleavage. Do you see it? Push it down a little bit more. There, so there's like just a little.
Probably just take it in right there. What about the back? Is it still?
Not closed.
It's not closed. Well, maybe we could put some netting or something there.
What if we like safety pinned it to a bra?
We could do that and then cover it with a veil.
It's a wedding dress. You don't put pins on your wedding day. You need to feel gorgeous.
You know what? If we make those kind of changes, it'll look like a completely different dress.
True.
I don't know if I want to reuse Ashley's dress though.
Let's give it a try, see what happens. We can always come back and look at the dresses again here if it doesn't work. I was pretty sure going to a traditional wedding shop was not going to be within our budget. But I wanted to give Brittany the traditional wedding dress shopping experience. And even though we didn't buy anything, it was definitely worth trying because you just never know what you might find. Now, I have a question for you, Susan. We didn't drink all this. Can we pour this back in the bottle and then take the bottle with us?
Yeah.
Can we do that?
No, I'm gonna try.
Okay, thank you. And then we'll just have it for dinner tonight.
All right.
Thank you.
You bring me to a bridal shop and brought my sister's old wedding dress. This is my day. This isn't my sister's day. This is my day. I'm very scared for my wedding.